Hello everybody, thank you for joining my YouTube channel. If you haven't already, like and subscribe. Today I'm going to talk about fibromyalgia again, continuation of the Lyme disease and the CFS discussion, chronic fatigue syndrome. So Lyme disease caused by a bacterial infection, a bacteria known as Borelia, burgdorferi. So it's from basically tick bites, as everybody knows. The result is a rash, a bullseye shape, headaches, and a fever. What's interesting is 10 to 15% of people also basically have what is called post-treatment Lyme disease syndrome. So remember that post-treatment Lyme disease syndrome, that's a real syndrome. So 10 to 15% of people that get Lyme disease will suffer at some point from post-treatment Lyme disease syndrome, or abbreviation PTLDS. Borrelia burgdorferi, it still exists in the blood in a lot of these patients that are part of this 10 to 15% range. This is a lot of times because tests, blood tests for Lyme disease are around 40% accurate at overall. So 4 out of 10 people, when they go get their, specifically their first blood test, there's a 60% chance that it's going to be wrong. That's basically what it means, that it's not going to detect Lyme. So these tests are far from foolproof. They will go into doing two tests to study antibodies that are harder to detect in labs. They will will see how many antibodies are reacting to this bacteria, and they will study its progression, and that's how they'll better determine whether your blood is inhabiting this Borrelia burgdorferi. So even without appearing in the diagnostic blood test for Lyme disease, like I said, the standard treatment can be up to as many as a couple years of these doxy or antibiotics. So that's a long time, and you'll understand why people that struggle with Lyme disease also struggle with depression and anxiety, because untreated Lyme, especially these 10 to 15% post-treatment Lyme disease syndrome that exists, is very hard on people. The treatment, amount of trying to purge this bacteria from the body, the reactions of your immune system, it's a huge, huge burden on people. And a lot of times patients will expect sympathy from their primary care practitioner or whoever they go to, but they don't understand a lot, and that's why they can't really sympathize with you, because in the medical world, there's a lot of bad things, from cancer to AIDS to other things these doctors are experiencing, and that delineates the things that they don't really understand, like Lyme. Remember, people use a scale in their mind to gauge people by how they determine what is more important on the life scale as far as disease. So that's why, personally, I do not seek out any emotional attachment or emotional connection with doctors or emotional connections with physicians. There's other people you can go to, family if you can. And sometimes family is even hard to deal with, so you have to seek friends. Doctors are not emotional companions, so don't use them as them. Another thing is that I found interesting. So this is important because a lot of times people will mix up the Lyme disease, they'll either do